shall overcome. Deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome. Though I join hands so often with students and others behind jail bars singing it, we shall overcome. Sometimes we've had tears in our eyes when we joined together to sing it, but we still decided to sing it.
We shall overcome one day. We shall overcome one day.
He had already been shot. Everybody was just horrified when he was shot. This March on Washington was already being planned by him, and that his people that were working with him continued it, and it became a kind of a memorial march. It was the Poor People's March on Washington.
No, we shall overcome.
No, for the victors won, even some will have to face physical death. Physical death is the price that some must pay to free their children from a permanent psychological death. Then nothing shall be more redemptive. We shall overcome.
What really drives me and that I'm passionate about is social justice, I think. I was a young woman. I was married to Reuben Greenspan, who is a photographer, and and I was holding down a full-time job, so I did not go down to Washington. He went down to Washington.
For the victory's won, some would be misunderstood and called bad names and dismissed as rabble-rousers and agitators, but we shall overcome.
I knew I was starting on a mural because I got a primed piece of canvas that long, and I put rollers, you know, big tubes in each end, and started in the middle. And then worked to each end. So I would roll it out and roll it forward, and so I had maybe 8 feet where I could roll it. I could never see it, the whole thing, at home. I only saw it once I put it up publicly. It's getting images in my mind of human consciousness being like an ocean, and that we were all joined in this ocean of the collective unconscious. So I have Martin Luther King with his eyes closed, floating in this ocean of the collective unconscious. And I have volcanic earth forms rising out of the sea.
We shall overcome.
The volcanic forms are people that have risen into consciousness, into the, like life, like land emerging out of the sea.
We shall all have peace one day. We shall all have peace one day.
And I had a young woman in Hayward come up. This was showing at the NAACP meeting in Hayward. And she started looking at this. And she recognized some of the people, and she started crying. She was 17 when she went on that march on Washington.
I know you're gonna miss me. I know you're gonna miss me after a while. And before I'll be a slave, I'll be buried in my grave. Take my place with those who loved and fought before.
Why is it important that people see this work now?
To bring to consciousness perhaps the fight for justice that is ongoing, you know. I think people need to know about it.
We shall overcome because the Bible is right. You shall reap what you sow. We shall overcome. Deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome.
Of all my early work, this is the piece that I would most want to find a home for. And you know, I hear stories of artists and dying and their work gets taken to the dump. And I really don't want this piece to end up in the dump. So I would really like a permanent home for it, somebody that would love it, and or a group, an organization that would respect it, love it, and understand what it means and what it comes from.
We shall overcome. And I'll tell you why. We shall overcome because the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends toward justice.